themselves aware that this extraordinary level of play or expectations of play can be obtained. And that happens. That's real.
Arts, thank you, Bond. You agree with Jerry Jones? This is a different Cowboys team since they beat the Saints on Thursday night?
Well, I think it's been a different team for a couple of weeks. I think there's a couple of different things that you look at. I think benching Connor Williams or Connor Williams getting hurt and Suofilo coming in and playing.
You keyed on that immediately when it happened.
It changed the tenor of their offensive line.
That's their left. They had a rookie left guard in there.
Rookie left guard who really struggled. Now, their offensive line hasn't been what it was, but it changed the attitude. It changed the tenor of what they did offensively. And obviously, you know, you have to recognize if you're a football team what we're good at, what we can do. But that changed just the dynamic of who they are and the way they ran the ball. And I think it was a gigantic move by them. And then you look at what they're doing on defense. You look at Van Der Esch. You look at Smith, the way those guys are playing right now. That front seven is nobody wants to face that front seven. They are nasty. And if they get you in a position where even if you're only down by seven, it feels like you got to throw it to get back in the game because they have played with such ferocity. So when they get you in that position, they can get to your quarterback and they can do it consistently. They don't have to blitz. They can blitz, but they don't have to. But that's really been the difference. They're playing with an aggressive style and an attitude that they didn't play with early in the season.
I said before the Saints game that if they won that game, I would start looking at them differently. And I knew they were on a good run leading right up to it. But that was, to me, I know they were only 7-point underdogs and they were at home. But that was a game I didn't think they necessarily would get blown out. But I said I would be shocked if they found a way to win it.
Sure.
And not only did they find a way to win it, it wasn't because they got a punt return touchdown and they had a defensive score. No, they won it on their terms. Mm. We're going to hold the total points in this game under 24. I was saying you can't hold the Saints individually under 27. Mm. They had only been held under 30 twice all year. Like, to me, what the Cowboys did Thursday night, what their defense did, was the single most impressive defensive performance any team league-wide has had all year long.
Sure.
To dominate the Saints offense like that. So I have to take them more seriously. I have to now look at them as a team that, okay, so they're going to have a home playoff game, probably be a favorite in that game, and then they will go on the road either to New Orleans or to the Rams. Prior to the Saints game, I would have said their absolute ceiling is being one home playoff win if they're lucky, and then dominated in the second round against a rested, excellent team. Mm. Now you have to look at them as a team that at least has a shot at pulling off that upset with the exact blueprint we saw Thursday night.
I mean, it's no different than we're looking at other teams. It just happens that we're talking about Dallas. Any team that's able to generate momentum, create turnovers, win big games, come up big in big spots, do things that you haven't seen them. So you have to take all those teams serious. If the team starts to be different than they were in November, in October, of course, those are teams. Dallas just happens to be one of the teams. You talked about it, that aggressive style that they have started to mount the last 4 weeks or so. You can start to see it. There's two things that I'm concerned about with the Dallas Cowboys. Number one, they played a great game last Thursday. And neither one of you guys necessarily picked up on it. It's hard to play at that energy level.
Right.
They brought some energy. Look at the amount of celebrations, how many times the team came together. Those are the little intangibles I watch when I watch a game. So not only were they excellent, is Jalen Smith going to be running sideline to sideline like he was running after Alvin Kamara in that game, the way he tracked him down and put that big hit on him? That's hard to duplicate week in and week out. The reason why I tell guys, man, practice on your fundamentals, because those things will come back to you if you feel good, if you don't feel good. So this is a young team, and we've seen this in the league, Mark. You can lean on emotion when you're a young team. You got more energy. Mm-hmm. You can be a little more reckless. As you start to become a veteran player, you understand, I must conserve my energy. Now, you as an offensive linemen think that all the time. Man, all that jumping around, celebrating. They don't do a whole bunch of that. It's hard to move all this fat. So that's something I want to watch in this Eagles game, divisional game. Do they come out? And I want it the same intensity. Same intensity,
right?
Because I believe with the youth of that team, that can carry them for a couple more weeks. I believe they can duplicate this. I'm excited to see the Cowboys, how they build on that tremendous win last week against the Saints.
It's easier to respond to failure than it is to respond to success.
Sure.
Because when guys have success, especially young teams, they're so busy patting themselves on the back that they don't prepare like they prepared for that game in New Orleans or that game at home against New Orleans. So
there's a fear component.
Right.
Like when you're preparing, you're like, man, I can get embarrassed. The details become very, very important.
And you get that. I mean, you get that with young teams. I mean, you get it with everybody. It's human nature. I think the other thing, you know, and I don't give Amari Cooper enough credit, but what they have done going out and getting Amari Cooper, at the time it looked like, oh, they gave up a lot for Amari Cooper. What he has done, the component of him being outside, and you have to be accountable for him. What that has done to their running game has also, the complementary nature of football. They've got a guy that strikes a bit of fear into you that,
yes,
you have to be concerned about. And what that's done to that side of the football field for their running game has been, it's been one of those things. I don't know how you calculate that, but it's been a huge step.
One thing that they've done is the defenses are playing the Cowboys very, very similar to when he wasn't there. But what happens is he's making the defense pay because they got so many guys in the box. If he makes one guy miss, and also Dallas has made the adjustment not only at left guard, but putting Michael Gallup on the outside. So him and Amari Cooper, they got more speed on the field.
Right.
Like they can take more shots at you.
They can put real fear into the defense a little bit.
Right. I mean, they became a lot faster football team by making those guys primarily the wide receivers outside.
We started the segment talking about the defense. This is a league where we saw quarterbacks are playing better. Offenses are putting up far more points. That seems to be the standard, except for the Dallas Cowboys. Is this defense, Nick, good enough to carry the team when their offense is not playing standard to the rest of the league?
To C's point, if they can play at the level they did against New Orleans, absolutely yes. Now, that is incredibly hard to duplicate, right? Like you were talking about, the fear of being embarrassed. National television, playing arguably the best team in football. Here's what I'll say for the Cowboys. Going into last week's game, you had New Orleans and Philly coming at home. If they could only win one of those games, the far more important game is the one that's coming up. Losing to Philly will undo everything that happened against New Orleans because it's a divisional game. It's the team chasing you in the division. So it can all be undone here in about 96 hours if they can't handle their business against Philly. But if they can, then you're talking about a team that's won five straight. You're talking about a team that knows who it is. They're a defense team with a great running back and, as you were talking about, one very good wide receiver who puts legit fear in opponent and another wide receiver, Michael Gallup, who, guess what? It's week 13. Doesn't look like a rookie as much anymore. Mm-hmm. It has a better idea of what the NFL speed is. And so that's where it is. They are playing. Them and the Ravens are the two teams in Seattle, I guess, kind of trying to play an older school style of football in 2018. But I know C believes that style is going to become more in vogue as the weather gets colder, even though Dallas doesn't have to worry about that. So we'll see how long they can keep it going.
All right, let's take a break. Mark, stick around. Coming up, could the Patriot way be the key to Aaron Rodgers winning another Super Bowl? We'll explain next. First things first.